Relatives and friends are paying their last respects to alleged hazing victim John Matthew Salilig. Bianca Dava now joins us with that story. Hi, Bianca. What can you tell us?
Stanley, family, friends, and loved ones of college student John Matthew Salilig, who died in hazing rites, continue to arrive here at a funeral home in Zamboanga City to pay their last respects. It was an emotional reunion for the family and friends of Matt when his body was flown home to Zamboanga yesterday. The grieving loved ones all wore a black shirt and a black armband. Matt's remains were brought here at the La Merced Memorial Homes. His coffin was placed beside his grandfather's, who died of multiple organ failure in February 22, just 4 days after Matt was reported missing. According to his father, Joffrey, Matt, being the youngest among 7 siblings, was the favorite of his grandfather. The family is now seeking for justice for Matt, who died in the hands of his fraternity brothers. Posters calling for justice are also placed and seen around the funeral home. Joffrey hopes that Matt is the last person to be victimized by hazing. He called on all those involved in the death of their loved one to surface and cooperate with authorities. According to Joffrey, the suspects and the persons of interest should not close their doors on authorities during the investigation. The Zamboanga City government also assured the family that they would provide all the necessary assistance in pursuing justice. Stanley, tonight a mass will be held here at the funeral home, and tomorrow the remains of Matt will be brought to his final resting place along with his grandfather. Stanley?
All right, thank you so much for the update, Bianca Dava. In other news, the former chairman of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, Efraim Gemino, or Genuino, will be spending time in prison after being found guilty of graft. Adrian Ayalin joins us with the details on this story. Adrian, over to you.
Yes, Stanley, former Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation chairperson Efraim Gemino was found guilty beyond reasonable doubt by the Sandigan Bayan 3rd Division this morning of one count of graft involving 37 million funds for swimmers in the 2012 London Olympics. In open court, however, Stanley, Genuino's lawyer said they will be availing all possible remedies. Genuino refused to respond to our query after the promulgation if he will be filing an appeal before the Sandigan Bayan. Also found guilty were Genuino's co-accused, former PAGCOR president and chief operations officer Rafael Francisco, and Philippine Sports Commission chairman William Ramirez. Genuino, Francisco, and Ramirez were sentenced to imprisonment of 6 to 10 years each, as well as perpetual disqualification from holding public office. Former Senior Vice President for Corporate Communications and Services Edward King and Assistant Vice President for Internal Audit Valente Custodio, meantime, were acquitted after the prosecution failed to prove their guilt. For another count of graft, Genuino was also acquitted by the court. The graft case of former Executive Vice President and Internal Audit Department Head Rene Figueroa was dismissed by the court, citing a Supreme Court resolution in 2022. In the information filed by the Ombudsman in 2016, 124 million PAGCOR funds were allocated for the development and training of swimmers under the Philippine Amateur Swimmers Association in preparation for the Olympics. 37 million was directly disbursed to PASA, a national agency under the PSC. PASA then used the money to pay for the aquatic training facility at the Trace Aquatic Center, a business allegedly owned and controlled by Genuino and his family. In his defense, through earlier manifestations before the court, Genuino said, among others, that the Commission on Audit had held that he had no control nor discretion over the funds and there was no basis to hold him criminally liable. Stanley, during the promulgation, only the dispositive portion of the decision was read, and the court has yet to upload the full decision on its website. The decision was penned by Division Chairperson and Presiding Justice Amparo Cabotaje Tang, with the concurrence of Associate Justices Bernalito Fernandez and Ronald Moreno. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Adrian Ayalin.